Hello students, I am Dr. Prakash Sarunke from Vatsan Institute of Technology, Mechanical Engineering Department. Today, let us discuss mechanical comparators. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain principle and working of dial gauges or dial indicator, which is one of the mechanical comparator. Dial gauge or dial indicator is one of the most widely used mechanical comparator. We can refer one. Yes, figure one. So this is the dial indicator. So if we see that, say it uses this dial and this rotating pointer as a display unit, hence the name is given as dial gauge. It has a sensing device in the form of a plunger or stylus which senses normally a linear displacement. Again, with reference to say this figure, so this is the semi plunger. So that is a sensing element and that will be sensing a displacement, linear displacement. It employs some mechanical means such as gears or levers, so which is not seen in the figure, so that is inside the casing, so that gears or lever mechanism is used for magnification. And say normally the dial gauge is mounted on some stand or some suitable base. Now it is not shown in this particular figure. According to IS-2092, dial gauges have been divided into two categories, type 1 and type 2. And these categories are made for general engineering purposes depending upon the movement of the plunger. So let us see. Type 1 dial gauge has the plunger movement parallel to the plane of dial as shown in figure 2. So this is figure 2. So this is the plunger. This is the plunger in two views. This motion of the plunger, so that is parallel to the plane of dial. So this is the plane of dial. And in type 2, say this motion of the plunger is perpendicular to dial. Perpendicular to dial. Yes. I hope you understood the difference. Now, these dial gauges are manufactured in two grades, grade A and grade B, with total plunger movement or lift of 3, 5 and 10 mm. So these are the three, of course, different ranges. Now, normally working of the dial gauges may have either display element may have either sector shaped or circular shaped. There are several mechanisms used for magnification of the displacement: lever type, gear type, or combination of these two. So these are very common. This mechanism of the instrument is housed in a metal casing. We have seen already this construction. Normally there are two pointers and two circular scale. Large scale is graduated in 100 divisions. Each division, say for a typical dial gauge, is of 0.01 mm. However, for more accurate gauges, it may be 0.001 mm. And there is a small circular scale and small pointer, say that indicates the number of revolutions completed by the large pointer. Now, dial indicator with gear and pinion mechanism. So these are very commonly used. So we are studying this particular mechanism. As seen in figure 4, this type of dial indicator consists of a plunger sliding in bearings and carrying a rack on it. So let us refer figure 4, then we'll understand. Yes. So this is the plunger. This is the plunger. So this is, of course, figure of mechanism only inside. So this is the plunger and it is sliding in, say, this particular bearings. In this particular bearings. And here, if you see, a rack teeth are cut on the plunger or that is attached to the plunger. Okay, so this is the plunger. This is a plunger which moves in this particular semi direction. The rack meshes with pinion P1. Pinion P1. Now let us try to understand what will be the function of this rack and pinion. So this here, this is pinion P1, so which meshes with this particular rack. Now what is the function of rack and pinion? Can you tell? Anybody of you? Just think. Yes. So rack and pinion, so this particular mechanism is used, say, to convert the linear motion of the plunger into rotary motion of the pinion, so that that will be convenient one. Now this pinion P1 drives gear G1, and the motion is further amplified through series of gears. We can see here that, say, this is the gear G1, so that will mesh with another semi pinion. So that pinion is mounted on a shaft on which one more gear is there. So this gear will in turn again drive one more pinion. So likewise, say, there will be amplification through series of gear trains, series of gear trains. And in each stage, say, there will be magnification in the ratio of, say, NG1 divided by NP1. So where N indicates the number of tooth, or there can be, you can also take diameter of that particular gear. So that will be having a larger diameter as compared to the pinion. Then again, gear 2 and, say, NG2 divided by NG1. So like that. So gear pairs. So that every pair, so that will add, multiply in the magnifications. So as we go on adding number of pairs, so there will be multiplication, say, in the magnification. Now, apart from this gear train, say, there is one coil spring that you can see at the bottom, so which is attached to the semi pointer. So that restores the, say, it is attached to the plunger, sorry. So that is that restores the semi position of the semi plunger. So let us see, say, here. Yes, so this is the coil spring. So this will, say, as the plunger moves upwards, say, this particular, a kind of diaphragm, so that will push, say, this spring, and the spring will be in tension, that will again bring back the plunger in its original or initial position. Similarly, there is one more spring here, which is called as hair spring edge. Now, this spring, say, that is attached to the gears, so this will help reducing the backlash. So that will, say, I mean, that will be working in this, plane in motion, circular, and, say, that will press the gears against the, say, I mean, another meshing gear, and that backlash will be removed. So rack guide, so that is one more element in this mechanism. So it ensures linear motion of the plunger as well as preventing the rotation. So if we see this rack guide, yes, so this is the guide, so this is the rack guide. So this, rod, so that will pass through the guide, so that will ensure linear motion of this plunger, as well as, say, that sometimes plunger will try to rotate in this semi-direction, so that rotation is also semi-prevented due to this rack guide. Now, large pointer is mounted on the last pinion in the gear train. If we see here, say, this is the last semi pinion, say, pointer, large pointer, so that will have a maximum motion, so that will be mounted on this last semi pinion of the semi gear train. And small revolution counter pointer will be mounted on some of the semi pinion here or here, so which will have a certain correct ratio, say, bearing to this, one complete revolution of this pointer will move one division of this particular pinion, like that. Okay, so this is the working mechanism of gear and pinion type of dial gauge. Now there are some constructional features of dial gauge. Let us try to understand them. So one is rotatable bezel. If we see any dial gauge, you will find, say, this particular bezel. So this is rotatable. This is rotatable bezel. So this bezel will enable us to, adjust the motion of the, position of the pointer to zero. Pointer at any position, so we can rotate, and that, say, zero can be adjusted to, say, this particular position. Then the contact points, the plunger has at the end has the contact point, which is normally spherical hardened steel contact point. So to have, a lesser wear, and sometimes it may be detachable, so it can be replaced with another. Then there are tolerance pointers. So there are two pointers which are not rotating, which are non-rotating. However, they can be moved, say, along the dial independently by means of the knobs. Independent means two tolerance pointers can be moved independent of each other. So they can be set as upper limit and lower limit depending upon the tolerance values. So by specifying the limits on both sides of the zero, the dial gauge can also be used as a limit gauge. So for fast operations. Now lever attachments, so these attachments enable to make internal measurements and to enable gauge some awkward corners and grooves, etc., say with ease. Apart from that, there are stands and holders, so these help in positioning and clamping of dial gauge as limitations. Say, I have taken the references from textbook of metrology by Mahajan and Dhanpatra and Company Private Limited. Thanks to them, and thank you.